Today we sit down with Corey and Akilah Carter of Verbal Connections and discuss how communication is vital in our everyday relationships. Also, Philly artist Gabe Tiberino comes to the studios and has brought along some amazing pieces. You don't want to miss it. This is Straight No Chaser. Let's serve it up. Good day, family, and welcome to another episode of Straight No Chaser. I'm your host and blog tender, Marquise Lufkin. Here on Straight No Chaser, we begin every show with the good news, so let's go out to our general assignment reporter, Joe Sewell, to see what's going on. Joe?
Do you like fitness, fun, and music? Well, after visiting Kyle Clark, that's just what we got. From getting down to getting your groove on, Kyle Clark shows just how his company is going to become the face of Philadelphia, one dance move at a time.
One and two and three and four. One.
Just So Street Dance Theater is spreading positivity through dance.
Our artistry does not begin until we stop thinking. Listen up, folks, listen up. Your artistry does not begin until you stop thinking. That's why we get you nice and tired. So now you can't think. Your body's too tired to think. It's going to react to what it hears. Yes? It's kind of sort of like primal instincts, like self-preservation.
Still only a couple years old, Kyle Clark and his wife, Danita, have seen this dance company grow in ways they were not expecting.
We started practicing together, and eventually we were like, well, we want to do some work. And it was for a showcase that we wanted to do, so we did the piece for the showcase, and everybody loved it and said, well, you should be doing more.
And more is what the Clarks did by first starting the Funky Soul Fundamentals Dance Class. This is a bi-monthly dance workshop that focuses on pop-locking, whacking, and educating dancers.
What Funky Soul Fundamentals is, it's a bi-monthly workshop where we provide quality education on the foundation and the technique of house and other funk styles under the umbrella of hip-hop.
And then the Clark stepped things up by creating the Just Soul Street Dance Team.
And Just Soul means just I, just me. In a world where everybody, you know, seems to be conforming to things, I wanted to find my individuality and be able to express that.
One and two, a three and four, five and six and seven and eight. Nice, all right, here we go.
By encouraging your personal growth and embracing your God-given gifts, Kyle Clark not only aims to mold flawless dancers, but also to be a mentor.
What I love about Just Soul is that it has a great balance between artistic development and a physical and technical challenge, as well as educational growth. They encourage you to find, you know, take whatever you've gone through in your life and take whatever, you know, whoever you are as an individual and use that in your dance.
Breaking away from his background as a technical classical dancer, Kyle Clark hopes to spread positivity through rhythmic moves across the city of brotherly love and beyond.
Because I spent so much time as a technical classical dancer, fitting and being a canvas, and for the first time I had the urge to be the artist, so that's where Just Soul comes around. Just Soul, just me, just I.
As a believer in Christ, I believe that, you know, we were given a gift, and, you know, once you have a gift, you don't put that candlelight under the bed. You spread that gift and that knowledge so that others can too experience the joy that you've learned.
The Just So Street Dance Music Theater meets every Wednesday at 7 p.m. inside the Community Education Center on Lancaster Avenue. This is Joe Sewell for Straight No Chaser.
Hello and welcome back to Straight No Chaser. This is Wit on the Street, and today I have the opportunity to speak with Buddy Rock of Buddy Rock and the Heartbreak Kids to discuss their positive music, their album, and their upcoming tour. So let's head on inside and get the scoop.
Who is Buddy Rock? Well, so Buddy Rock started, so back in the day, me and Alex, we used to sing in a singing group. It was kind of like a Boys to Men type, like a Latin Boys to Men type thing. And I was called Buddy Love back then. Didn't really want to be considered like a pretty boy type thing, so I changed it to Buddy Rock. Did my solo thing for a little bit. Now we have, you know, I did a little bit of production stuff, so it was kind of like a Latin freestyle kind of vibe, and then, you know, just bought the band, started singing with Alex again, and then we changed it. So the best way I can describe this is it's a little, a modern pop R&B group with very, very strong ties to old school sounds and themes.
I don't think there's any. I've never heard a band that's doing the kind of mixture that we're doing. It's, you know, most bands are kind of like indie hipster rock, which is really cool, you know, in its own right. Then you have the hip hop guys, which are really cool in their own right. But we're taking it right down the middle, and we're going down a path that really you haven't heard too much. We use classic setups, however, we use them differently. So we'll throw a Latin rhythm onto a jazzy R&B groove.
So you can come in, whether we're singing a ballad, whether we're singing an up-tempo song, you can go in there and dance. Slow, you know, we got slow jams, we got the high energy joints, and it's always a positive setting.
Some songs have come out of situations, whether it be, you know, a sad breakup or, you know, a loss in family or something like that. Other songs have come out of a fun idea. I have a problem writing songs that don't pertain to love and heartbreak. If you need a song that's about love and heartbreak, I can pump one out like 30 seconds. It's just something that I grew up on, listening to classic R&B, listening to classic Spanish music.
You know, I also really like singing like pop music, the stuff that we do now, like pop R&B, because, you know, that gets the crowd jumping. And, you know, while I can go and do my really deep stuff, I can do that on my own, you know, and still be satisfied, but then still play the pop music and then, you know, have everybody in the crowd, you know, dancing in one song and then everybody just listening and crying in the next, you know.
We'll make you laugh, we'll make you cry, we'll make you dance a lot, we'll make you... we haven't made anybody twerk yet, but we're working on that.
So when you go to Buddy Rock concert, you are celebrating life, you are celebrating music, you are celebrating culture, you are celebrating America. Maybe that was a little dramatic, but you know, that's what it is. That's about it. BuddyRockHBK.com. BuddyRockHBK.com. Or you can look us up on YouTube or Facebook, BuddyRock1212. That's BuddyRock1212.
Hello and thank you, and welcome to another episode of Straight No Chaser, a show that looks beyond sexy headlines and a vehicle for positive media here in Philadelphia. Family, today I want to discuss a national pandemic that has been glazed over for years, if not decades. Our ignorance as a nation to avoid such a pandemic has hurt our future and maybe the very demise of our nation. No, I'm not talking about the Ebola virus, which to date has only killed one American. With 4 confirmed cases, and only 2 of those cases originating in the United States. Which is funny because with 16 confirmed flu deaths in Pennsylvania alone, you don't see much of an uproar, but you know, that's none of my business. Family, I'm talking about the national pandemic of cheating. I mean, cheating has gotten so bad in our country that the teachers are helping the students cheat now.
Good evening. There's no harder lesson than the one taught today to 8 Atlanta educators by an angry judge after they were convicted on charges typically reserved for mobsters. He threw the book at them, teachers, principals among them.
These kids are winning.
Wow, winning.
But seriously, family, cheating is so much of a trending topic, they made a TV show about it.
Come on up. Now, ladies.
I just don't want to get hurt again. I'm tired of getting hurt.
Hey, what's going on?
This is my boyfriend for a year.
I don't know who she is.
You don't know who I am? Will you quit saying that? You don't know who I am? Do you not know who Zane is either?
Oh, wow. They're never getting back together. And this disease has even plagued our elected officials.
Democratic Senator Bob Menendez from New Jersey tonight facing an indictment. 14 counts. One count of conspiracy, one count of violating travel act, 8 counts of bribery, 3 counts of honest services fraud, 1 count of making false statements.
And even plagued America's sweethearts.
Was infidelity in a marriage, yes, on both parts. Both of us cheated on each other, you know, period. When two people that love each other as much as we love each other, when they start drifting apart, right, different people come into the situation, into the scenario, and we make mistakes. People make mistakes. We're human.
Not that there's any surprise there. I mean, anybody would cheat on Bobby Brown, but this cheating needs to be addressed because now more than ever, it's affecting the common man.
Today's announcement that Bottom Dollar Food will be shutting down its 66 locations, including the 46 stores in the Philadelphia region, had shoppers surprised.
Our homes and our neighborhoods.
People who are in any type of real estate development, they have taken over neighborhoods where they had large amounts of African Americans who were low income.
Right.
And they're trying to push them out by raising property taxes.
And even our education system.
We had cut all assistant principals, all guidance counselors, all music, all sports, all secretaries.
24 schools were closed. More than 4,000 employees were laid off.
But where do we start, you may ask? Well, it begins by paying less attention to stuff like this.
Hey, dirty, what? That girl right there, oh, she make me say,
oh, oh, yeah, oh, 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 oh